Hello and greetings from Iceland. This update is all about the next eruption and some of the incorrect information out there right now and how easy it is to misinterpret scientists like the civil defense in Iceland just did or something that could have led to incorrect headlines all over the world. And that story starts yesterday, Friday, with excellent news from the tourist board, their plans to open up the area around the crater. They seemed to be further along than when they first announced it the day before. So this was all over the media for a while, since it was revealed where the car park would be or close to the Blue Lagoon. So this looked great for a while for tourists, or until the civil defense came with an announcement saying that they were raising the alert level and preparing for an eruption that could start in the next few days. And the civil defense is in direct cooperation with the Met Office, which provides them with scientific information used for decision making. But it seems as the civil defense has in some cases scientific will on their own. And they took yesterday's report from the Met Office, where all possible scenarios were outlined, and they turned it into a sort of eruption announcement. The media picked that up instantly and called it out. It's gonna erupt soon and the whole package. But the report that came from the Met Office earlier that day, it was hardly newsworthy. The civil defense, they spiced up the scenario a bit. So I sat down last evening and made the first draft for this video. It could have been made into something with a good headline. But I had the feeling that it might be good to wait and see what some of the volcanologists would come up with. And lucky me, Professor Ármann Höskuldsson was in the news today, saying that he's not buying into this version from the civil defense. And furthermore, he believes that if anything, it is more likely to see the ongoing eruption flame out first or before the next event starts. And in addition, he says there has been speculation about that the magma that is accumulating will simply join the ongoing show, power up the eruption for a while, but nothing major, which is of course what we all want. So what we were left with after yesterday is a public institution whose role is to make decisions based on expert recommendations. So this questionable input from them was the biggest news story of the day yesterday. As I look at things, the civil defense don't want volcano tourism to start right now. And I agree. I said so when I spoke about this in my last update, that we should not move on with this project until we know how this new scenario will play out. And until this, I was under the impression that we were talking about weeks until the next eruption, not days. They just should have made it simple and said we have more uncertainty than we consider as acceptable risk. And I do respect that the civil defense is doing the right thing, but in the wrong way. And it leaves us with disinformation. The Icelandic headlines can get their own wings, often through bad translations. But as for me, first, after this statement yesterday from the civil defense, I checked all batteries like I always do before I hit the road. But I soon figured out that I might want to hold back, and it turned out to be right. But I do, however, need footage from the ongoing eruption and the ever-changing landscape there that I've been documenting all the time. And since the ice is melting from the roads now quite fast, I expect to go to the Reykjanes Peninsula after the weekend. And ending this short update with a little story of three tourists that got lost near the volcano tonight. It is not allowed to be there, so they must have done one of the detours. It's plenty of them. But they got unlucky and got lost in bad weather. And it didn't take our rescue teams a long time to find them, showing us how important it is to have those teams there, like in 2023, when they told several tourists to leave this area shortly before this collapse, showing us how necessary it is to have people there at all times. The Reykjanes Peninsula, it is not very big, but it can be very hard to hike there, like we have a lava field called Leggjabrotshraun, which means leg breaking lava, and there is a reason for that. So I think it's just best that we stay cool until this will be formally opened with all the assistance that you need nearby. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.